This teaching you're about to listen to was preached by Jegede Sunday Eve and recorded live at God's Family Bible Church, Trinidad. Jegede Sunday Eve is the General Coordinator of Arabs of Revival Ministries and the School of Discipleship. He is also the Missionary Pastor of GFBC, Trinidad, under the leadership of Pastor Abolaji Akimbo, the General Overseer of God's Family Bible Church Worldwide, Palm Coast, Florida. Listen and be transformed.
Father, we thank you. We give you glory. We give you glory. We give you glory. Thank you, Father, for sending your Son to give us life, life in his fullness. And thank you, Lord, because now we have your life in us, and so we have light. And Father, tonight, we declare, Father, that your light, Father, even as your word come forth, your light will flood every heart and every mind under the sound of my voice. Every barrier is broken, stronghold pulled down, in the name of Jesus. And we have revelation, we have illumination, we have understanding, and we grow in the revelation knowledge of Christ tonight. Thank you, Father. We receive your word tonight. And Father, Lord, as we receive your word, we declare in the name of Jesus that every sickness, every disease, every infirmity vanish away. Healing take place, deliverance, miracles, and victory. Thank you, Father. And in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Glory be to God. Once again, thank you for joining us in our service tonight. We really appreciate that. And don't just keep it to yourself. Invite your loved ones, invite your friends to be part of today's service. They will surely be blessed. Glory be to God. And I'm so excited tonight because we are starting a new teaching series. Glory be to God. And this teaching series, you are going to find it very enlightening. You are going to find it very informative, and much more is going to transform your life. This new teaching series is going to strengthen your faith because we'll be examining what God has already given to us in Christ and through Christ. Glory be to God. So we are starting tonight a new teaching series, and it is called Eternal Life. Eternal Life. So we are starting a new teaching series. The title is Eternal Life. And if you may, you can call it Everlasting Life. Eternal Life or Everlasting Life. And this is part one. Glory be to God. Now, I want you to pay close attention as we go into our Bible study tonight. So, Eternal Life, part one. Eternal Life, part one. Now, when simply put in a word, what God offer us in Christ Jesus, what God offer us, the gift of God, as it may be, the greatest gift of God that is given to us in Christ, that is given to us through Christ, is life. So why is it life? We are going to see in this Bible study. But I want you to know that if we put it in a word, what God offer to entire mankind, what God present to us, what God offer us as a free gift is life. Jesus said in John chapter 10 verse 10, New King James, John chapter 10 verse 10, the thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. But listen to what Jesus said now. I have come that they may have life. So when you ask Jesus, why did you come? Can you summarize it? Can you condense your purpose into a one word? Jesus will answer you, life. That is why I came. Jesus will tell you, I came to give life. I have come that they may have life and they may have it more abundantly. Goodness Bible said the B part, I have come in order that you might have life and have it in all its fullness. Life in all its fullness. New Living Translation says, my purpose. This is Jesus speaking. John chapter 10 verse 10, New Living Translation. The thief's purpose is to steal, kill, and destroy. So what is Jesus' purpose? So Jesus' purpose is to give us a rich and satisfying life. So you see that Jesus' purpose in a word, in a sense, is life, is to give us life. So why life? Why is life is what God offers us in Christ Jesus. Why? It is because life is our greatest need. Life is the greatest need of every man that comes into this world. So Jesus, in a word, came to give us life. And why did he come to give us life? Because life is our greatest need. And so why is life our greatest need? Do you know why? Because we are dying spiritually in Adam. The Bible says, 1 Corinthians 15:21, Paul says, for as in Adam all die. So we all die spiritually in Adam. That is why we need life. We all died in Adam, every one of us. So everyone that is born into this world is dead on arrival, spiritually speaking. So every man is born spiritually dead. Romans chapter 5 verse 12, Paul said, therefore, just as through one man, that is Adam, sin entered the world. Sin entered the human race. And look at what followed after sin. Death through sin. So sin came, disobedience came into the human race through Adam, and death followed. And death through sin. And look at the next thing. And thus death spread to all men. With no exception, death spread to all men because of sin. In Ephesians 2:1, Paul, writing to the church at Ephesus, look at what he says when he was referring, making reference to what God has done for them. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1 amplified, and you he made alive when you were spiritually dead. So Paul was saying, there was a time as Christian, as believer, that we were spiritually dead and separated from him, that is separated from God because of your transgression and sin. So what am I saying to you? In a word, in a sense, Jesus' purpose is to give life. And the reason why life was what he came to give us was because life was our greatest need. And why was life our greatest need? Because we all died in Adam spiritually. We were born spiritually dead. And what does a dead man need other than life? So we needed life, and thank God he sent his son to give us life. But pay close attention today. If Jesus came to give us life, and we are alive, so to say, physically, that tells you that the life Jesus came to give to us is not of the same kind and quality as the physical life that we have. So the life that God offered us in Christ, the life that Jesus said, I came to give, is not the human life. It's not the physical, natural, or the heavenly life that we possess via natural birth. What is that life? What is the life? What is the kind of life that God offered to us in Christ Jesus? Let's see that in John chapter 3. John chapter 3. 13 to 16, and I'm reading New Living Translation. The book of John chapter 3 from verse 13. Now, this is Jesus speaking. No one has ever gone to heaven and returned, but the Son of Man has come down from heaven. So, verse 14, and as Moses lifted up the bronze snake on a pole in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up. Now, look at 15 and 16. Pay close attention, so that everyone who believes in him, that is in Christ, the Son of God, we have what? Eternal life. Not the physical life, eternal life. So what Jesus came to offer us is eternal life. We inherited physical life, human life, via the natural birth, all right? But we are dead spiritually. But listen to this. So Jesus came to offer us something that we don't have. So Jesus came to offer us something that is higher, something supernatural, something divine, something heavenly, something that is of God. And the scripture called that eternal life. Look at verse 16. For this is how God loved the world. He gave his one and only son, John 3:16, New Living Translation. Make sure you open your scripture there and let's see. So that everyone who believes in him, that is believing in Christ, will not perish, but have eternal life. Now look at that scripture very well. So you see, the goal or the greatest goal of salvation is not that we perish. The word perish there is the Greek word apolomi. It means to devote to death or to destruction. Metaphorically, it refers to being given over to eternal mystery. It talks of spiritual separation, eternal separation from God in hellfire. So you see, so many a time we think that, oh, Jesus came just to deliver us from eternal ruin or eternal mystery, but it is much more than that. So the salvation we receive is not just for future deliverance or escape from hell. It's something that starts now. So the Bible says, everyone who believes in Christ will not perish, that is, will not go to hellfire, but now such one have something. And what is that? The Bible call it eternal life. Eternal life. That is what is called Aionios Zoe in Greek. And that is what we are going to study. So our Bible study, the teaching series that we are starting today, we are actually going to explore the Word of God to see what the scripture teaches about Aionios Zoe, eternal life. It is important because that is the greatest goal of salvation. That is God's greatest gift to all. In a sense, that is Jesus' purpose of coming, that we may have eternal life. And if you believe in Christ, you have eternal life already. But we need to know where we are so that we can enjoy it maximally. And so in this teaching series, we are going to investigate that. We are going to study eternal life, Aionios Zoe, very, very closely. And today is just introduction. And so in this teaching series, we are going to consider what is eternal life. What does it imply to have eternal life? I believe in Christ. And Jesus said, anyone that believes in me, have eternal life. So what does it imply to have eternal life? What is eternal life that I now have? And we're going to consider also the nature or the characteristics of eternal life. How is eternal life that I have different from the physical human life that I was born with? And of course, we're going to study, we're going to look at the manifestation or the expression of eternal life. How does eternal life express itself? We're going to consider that. And lastly, in this teaching series, we shall also consider how to receive and enjoy eternal life to the mass. What is eternal life? We are going to answer that. What is the nature of eternal life? In this teaching series, we are going to understand that. How does eternal life manifest itself? We are going to consider that. How do I receive and how do I enjoy eternal life? That is what this teaching series is all about, and I don't want you to miss any part of it. It is very important. Glory be to God. So let's go into eternal life part one proper. So in this part one, we shall focus only on what the scripture teaches about eternal life. What is eternal life? What does it imply to have eternal life? So what is eternal life? That is going to be our focus in this part one. So we are going to explore God's word to find answer to this question. So what is eternal life? What is everlasting life? Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Now, number one, I want you to know that eternal life is a divine life. That is what eternal life is. Eternal life is heavenly life. So eternal life is divine. It is not a human life. Eternal life is heavenly. It is not earthly life. Eternal life is spiritual life. It is not a physical life. And eternal life is supernatural life. It is not a natural life that every man is born with. Every one of us, if you are dead, hearing me, watching me, you have a life, and that life is physical, that life is human, that life is earthly, that life is natural. But what Jesus came to give us is something that is far, far beyond that, something that is completely different in kind, in quality, in nature, to what you are. What Jesus came to offer you is divine life, is heavenly life, is spiritual life, is a supernatural life. As a matter of fact, eternal life, now pay attention, don't miss this, eternal life is God's own life. Eternal life is the kind and the quality of life that God has, that God enjoys. Let's go to John chapter 3. Turn with me to John chapter 3. So eternal life is God's life. God's life, the divine life, the supernatural life. That is eternal life. That is eternal life. The kind of life that God has and enjoy. The quality of life that God has and that God enjoy. That is what we call eternal life. John 3, 35, 36. Now Jesus speaking, the Father loved his Son and has put everything into his hand. Verse 36, and anyone who believes in God's Son has eternal life. Do you believe in God's Son? If you are listening to me, watching me, and you say, yes, I believe in God's Son, then you have eternal life. What is eternal life that you are? It is God's life, God's own life. John 3:36, anyone who believes in God's Son has eternal life. And anyone who doesn't obey the Son will never experience eternal life, but remains under God's angry judgment. Nick and James will call it everlasting life. Now, what does that mean? The word eternal in John chapter 3 verse 36, or everlasting as you have it in New King James, is the Greek word called Ionios. What does it mean? Ionios means something without beginning and end. Something without beginning and end. That which has always been and always will be. So Ionios in Greek, A-I-O-N-I-O-S, means something without beginning and end, that which has always been and always will be. It means something perpetual. It means something that never ceases. So that what God gave to us is called eternal, everlasting life. And eternal means, it means it is a life without beginning and end. It is a life that is perpetual. It is a life that has always been and will always be. The word life there is Zoe. So eternal life is called Ionios Zoe. The word Zoe refers to absolute fullness of life, which belongs to God. Absolute fullness of life, which belongs to God. So when I say I have eternal life, what I'm saying is that I have God's kind of life. I have God's unending life. I have God's unceasing life. I have God's perpetual life. I have a kind of life that has no beginning and that we have no end. I have a kind of life that has always been and will always be. Glory be to God. That means I have a perpetual life as God has it. It's me. Pay attention today. When someone says, I have eternal life, what you are saying is that you have an indestructible life. You have life in its absolute fullness, just as God has it. So if you are a believer in Christ, if you are born again, you have something in your heart. It is called eternal life. It is God's quality of life. It is God's kind of life. It is a life that is indestructible. Death cannot terminate that life. Death only terminates physical life. But the life that you have is not physical. Death only terminates sickness, only terminates natural life. The life you have is not natural, it's supernatural. That is eternal life. The physical life ends in this world, but the life that you have is not a earthly life, it's an heavenly life. Glory be to God. It's a life that will never end. It's a life in its absolute fullness. It is a life that nothing is missing. Everything you need in life is in the life that God has given you. And that is why what Jesus gave us in the world is eternal life. Every other thing we need is in that life. Because that is the life that God has in himself. That is the life that God enjoys. And when we became children of God, that is the life that God shares with us. Glory be to God. Pay close attention to this. This is important. Eternal life is God abiding in you and you abiding in God. That is very crucial. very important. Look at 1 John chapter 4. We are considering in this eternal life part 1. What is eternal life? What does it mean to have eternal life? And we say eternal life is a divine life, supernatural life. Eternal life is God's life. Eternal life is in absolute fullness. And eternal life is God abiding in me and I abiding in God. 1 John chapter 4. I read 14 and 15, New King James. Now, we have seen, John the Beloved say, and we have seen and testified that the Father has sent the Son as Savior of the world. Look at verse 15 very closely. Whoever confesses that Jesus is the Son of God, God abides in him and he in God. That is eternal life. Now, you know, this same John, in John chapter 3 that we read, 17:36, he said, when you believe in the Son of God, you have everlasting life, you have eternal life. He's saying the same thing. He's not saying different thing, but he's using another terminology. He's using another verbiage to express it. He's giving us another concept of what eternal life is. So, whoever confesses that Jesus is the Son of God, he has eternal life. And that eternal life means God now abides in him and he now abides in God. Whoever confesses that Jesus is the Son of God, God abides in him and he in God. That is eternal life. So when I say I have eternal life, I'm not talking about a thing. I'm talking about I have God lives in me. Glory, hallelujah. Of course, the word abides here is the Greek word meno. It means to remain, to live continually, to live permanently. So eternal life means God has come to live in me permanently, forever, eternally, continually. That is what it means to have eternal life. John 14:23, look at the way Jesus put it. Jesus answered and said to him, when Thomas asked a question, he said, if anyone loves me, he will keep my word, my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him. That is what mone in Greek. It means we will make our abode, our staying, our dwelling resident, our permanent place. That word mone in Greek, which is translated home, actually refer to metaphorically the Holy Spirit in dwelling believer. So Jesus said, if you believe in me, then what will happen is that we are going to make our abode. The Trinity dwells in you. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit now dwell in you. That is what we call eternal life. So eternal life is the indwelling of the Holy Spirit in your heart. Eternal life, pay close attention, is the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. Eternal life is the Trinity, is God making his abode, his money in my heart. That is, I have become God's house. I have become God's temple, and he now lives permanently in me. That is what I'm saying when I say I have eternal life. Glory be to God. 1 John chapter 4. 1 John chapter 4, look at verse 13. By this we know that we abide in him and he in us. How do we know God abide in us? Because he has given us his spirit. And of course you know it is the spirit that gives life. John 6:63 amplified. John chapter 6 verse 63. So eternal life is God's spirit dwelling in me. Eternal life is God making his abode in me. That is eternal life. Eternal life. John 6:63 amplified. It is the spirit who gives life. So without the spirit, you don't have life. But life is that the spirit of God is in all. The flesh conveys no benefit. It is of no account. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life, providing eternal life. Can you see that? Glory be to God. That is eternal life. So eternal life is not just having something abstract. Eternal life is having God lives in you. Having God's abiding meno in you. That is what it means. Now pay attention to this. Eternal life also means, pay close attention, that now you have God's nature in you. That is what eternal life is. Eternal life is God's nature in your heart. Eternal life is God's power. Eternal life is God's ability available in you. That is eternal life. 1 John chapter 3 verse 9, New King James. Are you paying close attention tonight? Are you following me? This is eternal life part one, and we are considering what is eternal life. Eternal life is divine life, God's own life, supernatural life. Eternal life is God abiding in you and you abiding in God. Eternal life is indwelling of the Spirit in your heart. Eternal life is God's seed in you, God's nature in you. 1 John 3:9, whoever has been born of God does not sin, for his seed remains in him and he cannot sin because he has been born of God. The word seed here is the Greek word sperma. What does it mean? It means whatever possesses vital force or life-giving power. It speaks of divine energy of the Holy Spirit operating within the soul by which we are regenerated. So eternal life is the divine energy of the Holy Spirit made available in me. I would like to read that 1 John 3:9 in a few more scripture rendition. First, let me read New Living Translation. Glory be to God. 1 John 3:9. Those who have been born into God's family do not make a practice of sin because God's life. So the seed of God is God's life in you. That is eternal life. Now, goodness Bible says, none of those who are children of God continue to sin. Why? For God's very nature is in them. So eternal life is God's very nature in your heart. Are you following me? Look at the way contemporary English Bible put it. Those born from God don't practice sin because God's DNA remains in them. I love that. So eternal life is you having God's DNA. So when I say I have eternal life, what I'm telling you is that I carry God's DNA within me. Glory be to God. I carry the DNA of my Heavenly Father. I have his capacity. I have his ability. I have his power. I have his life. I have his nature. I have his love in me. Awesome. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Look at our contemporary English version. Put it now. Our common English version. It says, God's children cannot keep on being sinful. His life-giving power lives in them. That is eternal life. God's life-giving power in you. That means having eternal life. Pay attention. Don't miss this. Having eternal life is you possessing the spiritual capacity to live like God on earth. That is what it means to have eternal life. Because eternal life is you having God's DNA in you. Eternal life is you having God's ability, having God's power, having God's nature, having God's spirit in you. What that implies is that you have all that it takes to live like God on earth. Glory be to God. So when you have eternal life, you don't settle for a defeated life. When you have eternal life, you don't settle for a mediocre life. When you have eternal life, you don't settle for a depressed life. You have what it takes to live a triumphant life. You have what it takes to live an overcoming life. You have what it takes to live a fulfilling, prosperous life, just like Christ when he came to live on earth. Because you have God's DNA. You have God's ability. You have God's power. You have God's spirit. You have God's nature. You have eternal life. Isn't that awesome? Glory be to God. That is why Paul will admonish us in the book of Ephesians chapter 5 that we should imitate God. Why? Because we have eternal life. We have the life of God. We have his DNA. Imitate God, therefore. New Living Translation. In everything you do, because you are his dear children, live a life that is filled with love, following the example of Christ. God will not ask us to do that if we don't have his life. Because we have his life, we have his ability, we have his power. So we can walk as he walks. We can live as he lives. We can live above life challenges and circumstances. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. That is what it means to have eternal life. Are you still there? Are you following me? What does it mean to have eternal life? Number two, eternal life. Pay attention to this. Eternal life is not a thing. Eternal life is not a commodity. Eternal life is not something that God just throw at us. No. Eternal life is a divine person. Eternal life is Christ Jesus. This is important to understand. So eternal life is not just a thing that I have that I can just use whenever I want. And when I don't need it, I put it somewhere. No, eternal life is not a commodity that you shop for. No, eternal life, pay attention, it's not just a gift of Christ that when you say, Jesus, I need eternal life, and Jesus will stay there and then throw it at you. or just say, okay, get it. No! Eternal life, you can't have it apart from Christ. Eternal life is a divine person. Eternal life is Christ himself. Do you understand that? Eternal life is not just a gift that Christ gives. Eternal life is Christ himself. Eternal life is a divine person. So when I say I have eternal life, what I'm saying is that I have Christ living in my heart. I have Christ reigning in my heart. That is what it means to have eternal life. Glory be to God. Quickly follow me to 1 John chapter 5. The book of 1 John chapter 5. I want you to see what John the Beloved said about eternal life. So eternal life, number two, eternal life is a divine person. Eternal life is Christ Jesus. 1 John chapter 5, 19 and 20, New Living Translation. We know that we are children of God and that the world around us is under the control of the evil one. Verse 20, and we know that the Son of God, that is Christ Jesus, has come and he has given us understanding so that we can know the true God. And now we live in fellowship with the true God because we live in fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ. Now look at the next thing he said. So Jesus Christ is the only true God. He is eternal life. So you see, eternal life is not just a gift that God drops on our lap. It's not just a gift that God stays in heaven and then he rains it down on us on earth. No, eternal life is God himself. Eternal life is Christ himself. So when you say you have eternal life, what you are saying is Christ lives in you. That is eternal life. Eternal life is intimacy. Eternal life is communion. Eternal life is fellowship with God. You cannot have it without Christ lives in your heart. So Christ is eternal life. I want you to see the way 1 John chapter 1, John put it in this text. This is beautiful. This is awesome. Now turn your back with me to 1 John chapter 1. I read 1 and 2, New King James. He said, that which was from the beginning, which we have had, which we have seen with our eyes, we have looked upon and our hands have handled, concerning the word of life. So this is John the Beloved now writing. And he said, and the life was manifested. What life was he referring to? Eternal life. The life. That is Jesus. The life was manifested. And we have seen and bear witness and declare to you that eternal life, pay attention, eternal life which was with the Father was manifested to us. John said, Jesus Christ is the eternal life which was with the Father, but in due season, it was made manifested to us. So Jesus is the embodiment of eternal life. Christ Jesus is eternal life personified. Christ Jesus is eternal life manifested. This is important to understand. As we get to the expression or manifestation of eternal life, we're going to dwell more on this. But I need you to pay close attention to this. So eternal life is not a thing. Eternal life is Christ. Because Jesus Christ is the embodiment of eternal life. Jesus is eternal life revealed to us. Jesus Christ is eternal life manifested to us. Everything that Jesus did while he was on earth, that is what eternal life is all about. Is somebody listening to what I'm talking about? That is what eternal life is capable of doing. So as Jesus, he raised the dead, he healed the sick, he cast out demons, he walked on water, he calmed the storm, he performed miracles and wonders. That is eternal life in expression. Is somebody listening to what I'm talking about? That is eternal life in its full expression. That is eternal life. So eternal life is not just something that you are. Eternal life is Christ in your heart. Glory be to God. Because Christ is eternal life revealed. Christ is eternal life manifested. There is no eternal life apart from Christ. Glory be to God. Look at 1 John chapter 5. The book of 1 John chapter 5, 10 to 13. The Bible says, he who believes in the Son of God, I'm reading New King James, he has the witness in himself. He who does not believe God has made him a liar because he has not believed the testimony that God has given of his Son. So what is this testimony? That God has given us eternal life. So where are we going to get that eternal life? And this life, that this eternal life is where? Is in his Son, not in a religion. You can't find it in any religious leader. You can't find it anywhere in the market. You can't find it in any angel. You can't find it anywhere. Eternal life is in a person. Eternal life is in the Son of God, eternal life is Christ Jesus. Glory be to God. And so because it is in Him, that means it's the embodiment of eternal life. He is, so when you see Jesus, as Jesus came walking on the earth, that is eternal life walking. Is somebody listening to what I'm talking about? That is eternal life in action. The ministry of Jesus, all that He did, that is eternal life in His expression. Glory be to God. And the Bible says, verse 12, He who has the Son has life. So if you have Jesus, you have life. You have eternal life. Having Jesus is having eternal life. Having eternal life is having Jesus. He who does not have the Son of God does not have life. This thing I've written to you, will believe? Do you believe? If you believe in the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life. So if you believe in Christ, you have eternal life. And what that means is that you have Christ reigning in your heart. And that means you are able to do everything that Christ did. And much more, greater work. Because now eternal life is in you. Christ is alive in me. Christ is working in me. That is eternal life. Glory be to God. We're going to close with this. What is eternal life? This is eternal life Bible teaching series. And this is just part one. And what we are focusing on part one is to actually understand from God's word what eternal life is. What having eternal life implies. And we said eternal life is a divine life. Eternal life is a supernatural life. Eternal life is an indestructible life. Death cannot terminate it. Sickness cannot terminate it. Devil cannot terminate it. It is God's own very life. It is the kind of life that God has. It is the quality of life that God has. It's a perpetual life. It's a continuous life. Eternal life is actually God abiding in you. Eternal life is the communion of the Holy Spirit. Eternal life is the indwelling presence of the Spirit. And we also just learn that eternal life is not a thing. It's not a commodity. It's not a property. Eternal life is Christ. Eternal life is letting Christ live in your heart, letting Christ rule in your heart. And I want to close with this. What is eternal life? Number three, eternal life is they pay attention. You see, eternal life is not you existing or living eternally. Eternal life is not life after death, all right? Everybody is going to live after death. Do you understand that? Because we have immortal soul. Our spirit don't die, all right? So is it that you live forever in hellfire or you live forever in heaven? But whichever way, every man, every woman is still going to live after death. So that is not eternal life. Is somebody listening to what I'm talking about? So eternal life is not life after death or living or existing after death. No, eternal life is not a future promise. Many Christians think that eternal life is something that we are waiting to get when Christ comes or when we get to heaven. No, eternal life is what we have now. And you're going to see that in the scripture. So eternal life is not a future promise. Eternal life is not a future reality. It's not a future inheritance. Eternal life is not something I'm waiting to experience. Do you know something? Eternal life is a present possession. Eternal life is what I have now. Eternal life is my present experience with God. Eternal life is a present reality. Are you paying close attention? So eternal life is a loving relationship with God. That is what eternal life is. And we're going to see that very shortly. Eternal life is an intimate relationship with God. Eternal life is an eternal relationship. So it's a relationship with God that starts now and that will continue forever throughout eternity. Is somebody paying attention to me? Glory be to God. Look at John 3, 35, 36. We've read it before and let's read it again. Glory be to Jesus. John chapter 3, verse 36. All right, New Living Translation. And anyone who believes in God's Son has eternal life. Pay attention. Anyone who believes, do you believe in God's Son? The Bible said then you have something called eternal life, eternal life. Now, I want you to pay attention to the tenses of that scripture. The word has there is the Greek word that is called echo. It is E-C-H-O. Now, what it means is to hold something in your hand. It means to hold something. It is speaking of present possession. So the word has is not talking of what we are going to have in the future. He's talking about what you have now. That is what the Greek word heo means. It means your present possession. Something that is in your hand. Something within your grip. Something that you can use now. Is somebody listening to me? So eternal life is not something I am waiting to have when I die. No, eternal life is what I have now. He who believes in God's Son has eternal life. Eternal life is a present reality. Eternal life is a present inheritance, a present possession of every believer. It is not a future inheritance. It's not something I'm waiting to experience. Eternal life is what I am experiencing now. Right from the day that I met Jesus in my life, eternal life has come to live in me. Christ has come to live in me, and I'm enjoying Him now. That is eternal life. Every believer has eternal life now. Unfortunately, many of us are still waiting to enjoy what we already have now. That is why we are looking into this study, so that you can begin to enjoy what you have now. You don't have to wait until you die. You don't have to wait until you get to heaven. Eternal life is what God has given to you to start enjoying now. And of course, you are going to enjoy it after death. You are going to enjoy it forever. Because eternal life, Aionios Zoe, is a perpetual life. It's a life that has no beginning. It's a life that has no end. It's a life that will never cease. It's a life that is indestructible. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Look at John chapter 17. The book of John 17, New King James, from verse 1. Now Jesus spoke this word, lifted up his eyes to heaven, and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son also may glorify you. Verse 2, as you have given him authority over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as you have given him. Look at verse 3. Pay close attention. And this is eternal life. So what is eternal life? That they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. Contemporary English version put it this way. John 17 verse 3. Eternal life is to know you, the only true God, and to know Jesus Christ, the one you sent. So Jesus is saying, eternal life is to know Him. Eternal life is to know God. The word know there is the Greek word ginosko. Now pay attention. That word is much more than just having a knowledge. Alright? No. That word ginosko actually is used as an idiom. It's an idiomatic expression for sexual intercourse between a man and a woman. It is used to express intimacy, physical intimacy between a husband and his wife. That is what ginosko is used for. Of course, you see it's being used in Luke 1:34, in Matthew 1:24-25. Time will not permit me to go there. But I want you to know that the word know there express intimacy. It talks of experiencing something in an intimate way. So, eternal life now means knowing God, but pay attention, it is not knowing God mentally. It is not knowing some things about God. It is not knowing God intellectually. It actually means to know God intuitively. It means to know God experientially. That's what it means. It means to have intimacy with God, to have a relationship with God. That is eternal life. Eternal life is fellowship with God. Eternal life is intimacy with God. Eternal life is relationship with God. Is somebody listening to what I'm talking about? Praise God. Hallelujah. So eternal life is you having spiritual life. Eternal life is you having spiritual knowledge, understanding. All right? That is why now, pay attention to it. That's why you see that even college professors who are not born again, when they talk, some of them will look at all that God has created and they will say they are atheists, there is no God. And the Bible called them fool. Some of them simple spiritual truth, they don't understand. Do you know why they don't understand that? Because they don't have eternal life in there. Eternal life is light. The Bible said, we read that scripture, he said in him, John 1:4, we read it earlier, in him was light, that is in Christ, and that light, that is eternal light, is the light of men. It shines in the darkness. So eternal life gives you light, gives you understanding. You just know things about God intuitively without anybody teaching you. And when a teacher is teaching, when the pastor, you say, yes, I know that. I may not have a way to express it. I may not be able to express it nicely, express it expressively as the pastor is saying, but there is a truth within me. I just know it. That is because you have eternal life. That is eternal life. It is knowing God intuitively. Is somebody paying attention? I want to close with this. I read one more scripture and then we pray. Ephesians chapter 4, 17 and 18. I want you to understand it. Ephesians 4, so eternal life is knowing God intuitively, experientially. It's you having an intimacy with God. It is a communion fellowship with God. It is having an intimate, loving, eternal relationship with God. It is you understanding spiritual truth, because eternal life is life. It gives life. Ephesians 4, 17 and 18. This I say, Paul writing, therefore, and testifying the Lord that you should know longer walk as the rest of the Gentile walk in the futility of their mind. Now look at verse 18. Having their understanding darkened. Why is their understanding darkened? He's talking about those without eternal life, those without God. He said they have their understanding darkened. They are ignorant of spiritual truth. Why? He said being alienated from the life of God. Now, it says it is because they don't have the life of God. The word alienated here is the Greek word apallotrio. Apallotrio. What does it mean? It means to estrange. It means to be shut out from fellowship, from intimacy. It means to be a non-participant. So when you don't have the life of God, eternal life, you are shut out of fellowship from God. You are shut out of intimacy, and then you walk in ignorance. Your mind is darkened. Your mind is darkened. Glory be to God. So eternal life is you having the light of God in you. Is you having spiritual understanding. Is you having spiritual knowledge. Is you having ginosko, knowing God intuitively. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Our time has gone. We're going to continue next week. But I want you to know as we close tonight that if you are a believer in Christ, if you have truly believed in Christ and confessed Him as your Lord and Savior, you now have eternal life. You now have everlasting life. You are not waiting to have it. You have it now. John 6:47, Word English Bible. Most certainly, Jesus said, I tell you, he who believes in me has eternal life. You have it now. You have it now. I want you to rise to your feet wherever you are and you declare it. I believe in Christ. I have eternal life now. And what does that mean? It means I have the very life of God. It means I have God's DNA. It means I have the nature of God. It means I have the power of God. It means I have the ability of God. It means I have God lives in me. Glory be to God. Eternal life means you have the capacity to live an excellent life, a prosperous life, an overcoming, triumphant life, just like Christ did on earth. I have the life of God in me, and that means I can walk like God. I can speak like God. I can think like God. I can operate like God on the earth, because the life that God has in me, that is what He shares with me. That is eternal life. That is awesome. So don't settle for a defeated life. Don't settle for a depressed life. Don't settle for a mediocre life. Don't settle for a life of failure. Don't settle for that. You have something within you that can, and that enables you, that makes it possible for you to live an excellent life, to live an overcoming life. So why will you settle for a defeated life? I want you to rise up today, and you need to give full expression to the very life of God in you. Next week, we're going to look at the nature and characteristics of eternal life. Let's just bless the name of the Lord. Father, thank you. Thank you for giving us eternal life. We don't have to wait until we die. We don't have to wait till we get to heaven. We have it now to enjoy. We have the very life of God. We have Ionios Zoe, the absolute life of God. We have life in His fullness. We have Christ now living in our heart. We have the Spirit of God indwelling us. We have the power of God available to us. We have the DNA of God right now. We can do the work that Christ did. We can do greater work because we share His life with Him. Father, we thank you.
We have a life that sickness cannot destroy. We have life that death cannot terminate. We have a perpetual life, a very indestructible life, the very life of God. Father, I pray that as we go continuing this teaching series, that our hearts will be open, our eyes of understanding will be enlightened. We will begin to see eternal life. We begin to understand what it is. And Lord, we begin to give more expression to this life of God that is inside of all. And Lord, we ask in the name of Jesus, that this life of God will manifest fully, just as it manifested in Christ. Father, we thank you. We give you praise for eternal life. We celebrate this gift of God. Thank you, Father. And in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Glory be to God.
We hope you have been challenged, encouraged, and motivated to become more like Christ by today's teaching. If you would like to find out more about Eras of Revival and get additional teachings and materials for your healthy spiritual growth, visit our website today at www.erasofrevival.org. Or if you would like to enroll at our School of Discipleship, visit our website www.theschoolofdiscipleship.org.uk. This teaching was made possible by the prayers and generous free will offering, donation, and gifts from partners like you. You are welcome into partnership with us today. For information on how to become a partner, please call 1-868-292-9270 or 1-868-703-5572. Or you can email us at info@erasofrevival.org.uk. Thanks for listening.